Bom dia. Well, thank you for inviting me here, and I'm happy I managed to arrive on time with all the delays in the flight. I went a bit too quick. My name is Virginia Dignam. I'm Portuguese, even if you don't realize from my Swedish background and my Dutch surname that I'm very much Portuguese. Responsible artificial intelligence. It cannot be a secret for no one that artificial intelligence is really hot at the moment, that you cannot open a newspaper or listen to any news on TV without someone discussing some issues, dangers, or possibilities of artificial intelligence. Especially in Europe, we are increasingly realized that if we want to develop artificial intelligence in a way that really can benefit all of us, then we have to take a responsible and social approach. Actually, just in his State of the Union speech yesterday, Juncker was referring to this, which is the work we are doing now at the high-level group on artificial intelligence. Why is it important to consider the responsible issues, the ethical aspects of artificial intelligence? The main idea is that, in a sense, given the developments in AI, AI is going, and we are seeing that already now, actively and increasingly acting autonomously in our world. There is also this idea, this hope, this desire that AI eventually will become able to make better decisions than ourselves. But this idea of better decisions depends a lot on what we are telling AI and how we ourselves behave and how we ourselves are making our decisions. Because AI is not, it's not some kind of a magic wand which comes and starts doing things by itself, but it's very much an artifact. It's a tool, it's something that we design, and we should design it for the purpose that we want. The sentence I have there, the quote I have there, it's from Stuart Russell and based on Norbert Wiener, and it already says that we really need to know what purpose we want these systems to do before we start building the systems, because the system will follow the purpose that we want, so we have to make sure that this is really what we want. And knowing what we want, knowing what is right, knowing what is wrong, is the realm of philosophy, is the realm of ethics. And it's something which, in a sense, we very much are realizing that we have to be much more concerned and much more based our decisions for this type of systems, not only on the engineering possibilities, not only on the optimization for a certain speed or a certain functionality, but we really have to build these systems to optimize to what we feel it's right and what we feel as a society that it's right. Of course, this is much easier to say than to do, and we have been discussing that at many levels, and the ideas are that actually to really take this a next step, we have to start considering to take an ethical approach to the processes that we use to develop this type of systems. At the same time, we have to look about how is the reasoning algorithms, what are the kind of mechanics and the tools that these systems use to deliberate, to make a decision, to come with to do an action, and see, can we build those algorithms to be able to be ethical in itself? That's a very wide and very open area of research, but in a sense, we would like to integrate ethical reasoning, so the system being able to perceive itself what would be right or wrong. But also, last but not least, it's also about the responsibility that the developers, that policymakers, that manufacturers, that users have about what we are developing, what we are using, what we are allowing into our societies. So I will go very quickly through the three of them. Concerning the processes, the methodologies to develop this type of systems, one of the approaches, and there are many, every day you will get more presentations or more announcements of yet another list of guidelines from another country or from another organization and so on. But basically what we want with this type of methodological guidelines to develop systems which are responsible and ethical is that we take into account the accountability of the system. And that is about ensuring that we know in an explicit, open and transparent way how the values that were behind the decisions that were taken to develop or to deploy a certain system are transformed into the rules of those systems and further down into concretized into the functionalities. We are also concerned about responsibility. And responsibility in this sense is about what type of autonomy we want to give to these systems. Do we want the system, the car in that case, to be autonomous in the sense of determine which action or which plan it should take to bring you somewhere? Or we want these systems to be autonomous in the sense that they decide for yourself where you should be going? Probably not. We also have to be very clear and very precise and very open about who were the actors involved in the development of these systems and what type of decisions they can or not be liable for. And finally, we have to look about transparency. And there is a lot of discussion about transparency, about transparent algorithms, about bias in algorithms, about data and so on. But basically, the point is that in any algorithm, in any system, in any decision that we take, we make a choice. And we have to make choices, and all the time we have to make choices and prioritize different types of values, different types of principles at different moments. So by ensuring transparency of the systems, can be done in many different ways, but the idea is that we make clear what were the options and what were the alternatives and the priorities we gave to those options. Make explicit and clear what were the choices and decisions that were taken. Then the second one about can we build systems that are ethical? These are machines, are pieces of software, are wires, are plastic and iron. Can we make these things to be ethical? There is a lot of discussion, there is a lot of work on this. The answer is not, the jury is not out yet, but one of the things is what does it mean for a machine to be ethical? And then if we could do that, what is needed? And I'm just going to give you a short example, and it's not at all pretending to be the right thing, but imagine that one of the things we see, and the example is again from the self-driving cars, not because I do believe that those cars should be ethical in themselves and deciding what they should take, but it's because it's an example that has been given many times, and it's easy to follow. So what we can do in terms to determine if the car gets into those situations in which it can only choose between two bad things, kill its own passengers or kill the people in the street or harm them, then we can take the approach, let's ask the people, let's ask the world, let's create, I don't know, an election or a referendum and ask what should the car do. We aggregate all those options that everybody thinks and we build a car to be built in that way. That would be an approach. I wonder if ethics by crowdsourcing is something which we would want, but that would be an approach. Another one which we see quite a lot around is go look at what the ethics, the philosophers tell us. And the point here is that philosophers tell us many different things, and they are so abstract in what they say that we can interpret it in many different ways. And I will just give you a very simple example. We can build an utilitarian car, which will just count the number of victims and choose the list of them. We can build a car based on Kantian principles or on deontology, and that one will try to mix it, to avoid actions which it knows that it will cause harm. So it will stay in its course of action and not do nothing if it knows that it will cause harm. Or we can build an Aristotelian car, which probably would be very concerned about taking care of the least advantage. And of course, if we go this way, we can soon go to the shops and start buying the car which fits our principles the best. So this is not at all the idea that it will be like this. It's just to show that it's a very complex and that even if we are going to base it on the ethics that we have as people, it's still a lot of choices that have to be made. And we ourselves are notoriously bad in making this type of choices and to explaining those type of choices. So maybe we should be very careful on pretending to go build systems that can this choice for us. And finally, we should be looking at the ethics for the designers themselves. A lot of professions have regulations, have codes of conduct. Maybe the time now is that also developers, software developers, and in particular AI developers, should start also have some code of conduct. Because what we want at the end is to ensure that AI is built for good, is built for people, is built for all of us. And there are many activities and many actions around the world trying to do this type of things, but there is a lot of issues, many more questions than the answers at this point. And the issue here is that actually we are the responsible ones. And by being the responsible ones, we really have to be sure what we want these systems to be doing for us. Thank you.